What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I have a very exciting video for you, one that I've been kind of working on for the last couple weeks and one that I'm very pumped to get out to all of you rogues out there. And this is something that you're going to want to share with your entire guild. If you are either a rogue, if you are a raid leader, no matter who you are, you're just going to want to share this video with your entire guild. Now today what we are going to be breaking down is improved expose armor and how much of a DPS increase it is, if it's worth using this, which specs are viable for using improved exposed armor, and pretty much everything you need to know about improved exposed armor. As you probably have seen, if you watched the Onslaught new world record, and when I broke that down, they did run an improved exposed armor rogue. And as well, most of the other top guilds in the world doing all of these speed runs and even doing parse runs have been running an improved expose armor rogue. So today we're gonna find out why they're running it and what specs or what combinations they're using to run this, and if they're viable for you or your own guild, what you need to do to be able to run this, what the rotation is to be able to run this, and some of the comparisons. We're gonna touch on pretty much everything I can today. And before we get into it, as usual, feel free to join our Discord where we are doing a lot of theory crafting. I also have a lot of vlog reviews, VOD reviews. We've got sub-only videos and a lot of sub-only content in there for Twitch. Also, follow me on Twitch at twitch.tv/sarth. And of course, if you like this content, please like and subscribe. It helps me be able to do this more for you guys. And from there, let's do this. Let's dive right in. Oh my gosh, I'm excited, guys. Let's go. Okay, guys. First off, I want to break down exactly how good exposed armor is for you guys. And as I was looking for some specific numbers other than the tests that I have done myself and seeing those numbers, there is an actual guide that Simonize actually released, and it's on Wowhead, and he's one of the sickest rogue theory crafters out there. So I will link this in the description. Also, he has a crazy, crazy Excel sheet that's extremely helpful as well. So make sure you check that out, guys. Let's check out exactly how good is the exposed armor reduction. So most bosses sit at level 63 and they have 3,731 armor. With your normal debuffs, including Fairy Fire, Curse of Recklessness, and Sunder armor, the boss has 336 armor left, which is a 5.75 physical damage mitigation. If you use a 5-point expose armor though, the boss goes down to 36 armor, almost zero, which puts him at a 0.65 physical damage mitigation. This is more than a 5% physical damage increase for all of your melee in your group. If you are melee stacking, this is actually massive. So all speed runs, all parse runs, this is huge. The cost to the DPS of the individual rogue is decently minimal, and it actually changes between what specs you're running, and we're gonna dive into that next. But the cost of DPS that it does to your rogue, your singular rogue, has to be less than the increase it does to your overall raid. The breakpoint seems to be between 1200 and 1700 physical DPS total throughout your entire raid, which any raid with even a decent amount of melee is gonna completely shatter that easily. So it is such a huge upgrade for pretty much every raid, but there's a couple things that you need to keep in mind here. If you drop expose armor for even a second, the boss goes up to a 31.98% physical mitigation. This is huge, like absolutely massive. If everyone doesn't know how important it is to have 5 Sunders up as a first global for every warrior, you have an even more important job as the exposed armor rogue in your raid. Now, it only takes a few seconds of exposed armor to fall off for the entire benefit to be completely mitigated. So if you drop exposed armor for more than 1 to 3 seconds, you are fully becoming useless. And you're actually being more of a detriment to your raid than you are a benefit. If this is gonna happen, make sure that you tell your warriors that they need to reapply Sunder armor the second it falls off. Another thing to mention right before I get into things even further is that you do need to let your tanks know that you will be running improved exposed armor. And the reason for this is because they no longer can use Sunder Armor to rage dump. Without being able to Sunder Armor the target, it is a huge detriment to their threat if they're not using their rage in other ways, which is Battle Shout and Demoralizing Shout. And these rage dumps actually cause decent threat in comparison to Sunder Armor, so there is no real worry here for their threat and the threat loss, especially for Horde. That's where we're kind of worried about threat. There's not really gonna be that worry, specifically if your tanks are ready and they have their shouts macroed and bound perfectly. Doesn't really need to be a macro, but if they have them bound and they are ready to cast their shouts pretty much as often as possible when they need to rage dump. I do also want to mention that it is very important, pretty much vital, that your exposed armor rogue has Renataki's Charm of Trickery, as well as many Thistle Tees as possible. Because you're actually gonna kind of stagger these on different bosses where you have one of these cooldowns up on each individual boss. So say you're fighting the Drakes in Blackwing Lair. On the first boss, you can use Renataki's Charm, and then you can swap onto a different trinket if you need to, and then on the second Drake, you can use Thistle Tee. And then back on Chromagus, you need Renataki's, and then back on Neph, you're gonna need Thistle Tee. So these are actually crucial to applying improved exposed armor in the shortest amount of time possible. And on that note, I actually as well want to mention that this is your first finisher. You are not applying Slice and Dice to yourself before you get exposed armor up on the mob or boss. It is absolutely crucial that your very first global, you are burning combo points as fast as you possibly can to get exposed armor up on the mob instantly. Now there are three main specs you can use for improved exposed armor. You can use the Hemo spec, you can use the Combat Sword spec, basically the exact same Combat Sword spec as you usually use, except for you have exposed armor. And lastly, you can also use this combined Seal of Fate spec, which is a Sword Seal of Fate spec. And the reason why you would use this instead of a Backstab Seal of Fate spec is specifically so that you can get combo points up as fast as you can, but really you're kind of trying to manage your energy costs. And if you're using Backstab, it will change the breakpoints for when you need to pool energy. So be aware of that. I wouldn't suggest using the Dagger spec or Backstab spec Seal of Fate, because the extra cost of energy to gain combo points is detrimental at this point. You're not going for your overall DPS, you're going for the entire raid's overall DPS. So before I show you guys all of these specs, I've been talking to a lot of different rogues out there in a lot of the top guilds in the world, and one of the rogues that I've talked to probably the most, and he's been extremely helpful in breaking down all of the numbers, the breakpoints, and us testing a lot of things together, is the rogue Simpleton. So shout out to you, man, thank you for helping. And his guild has a 22 minute clear, one of the top guilds in the world, and he has done a lot of theory crafting, as well as I've done a lot of theory crafting and testing all of these. Okay, so what do I think about the three different specs? In Onslaught's run and a lot of other speedruns, we're seeing people run the Hemo spec. So for Hemo spec, guys, if you're running the Hemo spec and trying to get exposed armor up as fast as you can, you actually seem to be doing about around 50 to 60% of your normal DPS, even with GM weapons, so rank 14 weapons, and still doing about 50 to 60% of your DPS. So this means it is a big enough DPS loss, usually on average, for it not to be fully applicable for your entire raid, even if you can get the combo points up quickly enough for you to be able to get exposed armor up very quickly. If you're running the Hemo spec, if you have infinite energy, you're boosting the raid DPS, overall raid DPS, by 210 then. But if you lose around 500 to 700 DPS yourself, that's not an actual increase to the overall raid's DPS. And that 210 DPS increase is a best case scenario where your raid is physically hitting the boss 30 times every single second, which is harder to do for Alliance than it is for Horde because of Wind Fury, but still, that is just an optimal scenario, and it's still a DPS loss. Now, this was a spec that was run, and in all logic, because you would think that HemoSpec is usually just a combo point builder, it seems like this is the optimal spec to use for exposed armor, but by doing all of the math and breaking everything down and testing it, it actually is more of a detriment to yourself than it is an increase to the overall raid. And all of the specs we're going to use are still going to be a DPS decrease for yourself, but they will increase the DPS for the raid, and the real thing you need to watch out for is more of that breakpoint. So I just wanted to talk about that really quickly. We did see a lot of the top guilds use this and in their speedruns, and I'm curious if they're actually going to switch away from that spec after they test different things, like test the combat sword spec as well as the Seal of Fate spec. So let's see how those compare. So the main spec most people are going to be running is the combat sword spec with the variation where they add exposed armor. So it's a normal combat sword spec as you can see here, and I currently am running a combat fist weapon spec in the sims and the tests because I don't have a sword to combo with my Thunder Fury. And I know that honestly sounds so obnoxious, but let's just move on from that. Things with exposed armor completely change up your cooldown usage as well as your slice and dice time. If you have no cooldowns, like if you have no Thistle T, you have no Adrenaline Rush, after you put up a 5-point exposed armor, you're building combo points until around 22 and a half to 23 seconds. That's where you're gonna pop your slice and dice and then build combo points again to make sure that you get exposed armor up again on the boss or mob, of course, before it falls off. This is crucial again, guys. You cannot let exposed armor fall off, so you need to trust the rogue doing this because they have to get used to their actual rotation. And on that note, I would say it's great to go to the PTR or just go into Dire Maul and just test out your rotation. Literally just practice your rotation, because there were times when we ran the run last night, and I'm going to show you guys, that I had to pull rage because I didn't realize when I was using my cooldowns. I would use my cooldowns right after using the first exposed armor, and then I would wait too long to be able to use my slice and dice instead of going for another exposed armor. So this is pretty crucial. Getting used to the rotation of making sure you keep exposed armor up on the boss is very, very crucial. And it's also important to note here that you do want to know your average kill times of these bosses, because sometimes you might only need to get that first exposed armor up, but other bosses you need to get more than one, more than two, possibly three exposed armors up. It depends on how fast your kill times are. So the breakpoint again for when you need to start building combo points and pooling energy for exposed armor to make sure that you have 100% uptime once you get the first one up is around 22 and a half seconds, or if you have Adrenaline Rush, it's around 18 seconds. That's because with the 5 Sinister Strikes and the exposed armor, it takes a total of 225 energy to get a new exposed armor up. When you're running this build, you're actually going to have a uptime of your slice and dice at around 40%. Which obviously isn't great. For most rogues, you kind of always want to have as much of an uptime of slice and dice, as close to 100% as possible, but for this build, you are much less concerned with having slice and dice up as having improved exposed armor up on the boss. So for the first test we're going to be doing, I'm going to be running the combat sword spec. I'm going to do a timer as well so that you can see how fast exactly we get the exposed armor up on the mob. So it takes about 6 seconds to get exposed armor up on a mob. Now the next spec I want to show you guys is the Seal of Fate spec, which I only tried in Dire Maul, and I compared the DPS. I was doing actually comparable DPS, even sometimes slightly better DPS overall than the combat sword spec. So it's very close as long as you have world buffs. It is a decent spec you can run, and you can get exposed armor up significantly faster. So I'm curious to test this out in actual raids. Seal of Fate obviously gives you a 100% chance to get 2 combo points whenever you crit a combo point maker. And as well, you have cold blood. So no matter what on your opener, if you get 3 combo points, then you're gonna use a cold blood sinister strike. So just macro those two together. With this spec, I was able to get exposed armor up at around 4 seconds. It's 4 globals instead of 6 globals, which is actually huge. You're getting it up 2 seconds earlier on average, and if you are doing comparable DPS, then this actually will be a huge increase for everyone. The challenge, the biggest challenge with Seal of Fate here is actually that it's harder to time out or to exactly map when you need to start building combo points for your next exposed armor. And that's because there is a lot more RNG involved with getting crits to get double combo points, and sometimes you actually find yourself stacked on combo points for much longer than you want to be, or you're gonna have to pool energy or just sit there and wait. For the most part, you can just continue to sinister strike because you don't want to risk the chance of you using your eviscerate and then not getting 5 combo points back and letting exposed armor fall off. And this becomes even more crucial during execute phase on any of the bosses, but there's some bosses where you're only gonna have to use 1 exposed armor. When I tried this out on the PTR, we actually did a 25 minute run, and that increased the DPS of our warriors by a significant amount. Actually, all of our melee DPS did a lot more damage than they've ever done before, and we didn't have Darkmoon Fair. So this is gonna actually compound exponentially as we get better gear and with Darkmoon Fair. So exposed armor, having 1 exposed armor rogue in your group or in your raid is gonna be huge, guys. You definitely want to do it, but you do want to trust that rogue, because if it falls off again for more than a couple seconds, it is more of a detriment to the entire raid than it is a benefit. Now, of course, if you are chosen to be that rogue that's doing the exposed armor, it is going to slightly gimp your own DPS, so be aware of that. And a lot of times it might be like rogue class leads or rogue officers that have to take the hit, or someone that's trustworthy. Ideally, it would be your lowest DPS rogue, and you would be able to trust them to make sure that they keep this up on the boss. But I've heard that sometimes people are trusting different rogues to keep this up, and they're actually letting it fall off for multiple seconds, and it's becoming, again, more of a detriment to the raid. When I was testing this out as combat sword spec, it takes between 6 to 9 seconds to get your first 5-point exposed armor up on the boss. But as Seal of Fate spec, because instead it only takes 4 globals, ideally you can get exposed armor up on the boss around 4 seconds. Now, an important thing to note here is if you die and lose your world buffs, it is going to significantly reduce your chances to get those crits, and so you are going to get this up at a slower pace than you would usually expect. So running the Seal of Fate spec is possibly optimal, but it's scarier because if you lose your world buffs, you are sort of gimped. And that's always like the big fear here, is whenever you're running Seal of Fate spec, everybody who wants to do it, if you are anticipating dying and your guild actually wiping and losing world buffs, it could be a DPS loss than just going with the normal combat sword spec. So with Seal of Fate, the timer where you need to start building combo points in an ideal world is actually 13 and a half seconds, because you need 60% of the globals that you usually do as combat. So it's about 13 seconds, but you actually want to leave yourself some leeway of about 3 to 4 seconds. So I would do it around 16 to 17 seconds where you start building combo points in case you don't get those crits. And if you are ever worried about capping out on combo points and wasting combo points, honestly, that's not as much your fear here, as your entire purpose is more so to make sure that exposed armor is up 100% of the time that you can on the boss. And that's that, guys. Let me know if there's anything I forgot. I'm trying to think if there's anything I forgot, so let me know in the comments. If you liked this video, as always, make sure to like and subscribe. If you have any questions or you want to do any more theory crafting with me, or you want to see me theory crafting and testing out the Seal of Fate build on the PTR and in other raids, make sure to come and hang out on our Twitch, twitch.tv/sarth. I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Friday, and Saturday right now. Also, feel free to join the Discord where we do a lot of theory crafting and we have a lot of other things. If you haven't seen already, I'm building a spreadsheet that actually maps out the exact DPS increases of every single weapon throughout the game, and I'm building it out to now have all the increases of every combination, every single individual item, and as well, I'm gonna have all of the BIS lists in there and build out all of the specs and everything, pretty much a one-stop shop for rogues. So make sure that you add that, and that's in the description or in the Discord channel, and keep up to date with that. I will be updating this basically weekly. As usual, my name is Sarth. Thank you guys for watching, and feel free to like and subscribe because it does help me be able to make more of this content for you guys. I'll catch you guys all in the next one, and peace out.